Hi, in this video I will try to fix my 2016 MacBook Pro. As you can see, this is the entry-level model which has does not have the touch bar and has the function keys instead, and this is important. And at the moment I'm booted from this external drive, and as you can see, both the external drive and the internal drive show up in the system. But let's see what actually happens if I try to run Blackmagic disk speed test on the internal drive. So let me select the target drive, Macintosh HD, open and start. And you can immediately see that something is not right, because the application appears to be frozen. And we have kernel panic. So we get the dreaded message: your computer was restarted because of a problem. And if we open the crash report, we can see that the problem is in Apple's NVMe storage driver. So basically it is the internal solid state drive that is faulty. So let's also check the status of the internal drive using SmartMon tools. The drive still has 89% of available spare capacity, and the total wear is just 4%, and the total amount of written data is 37.7 terabytes. So I would say that this drive is well used, but it should not fail catastrophically. But in fact, this is exactly what happened. So this drive has failed, and I need to replace it. To fix this problem, you will need several things. So obviously, you will need a new solid-state drive. So in my case, this is Sabrent Rocket Nano. And this is very important, because you will need a 2242 solid-state drive. So not 2280. 2280 is too large, and it would not fit inside the laptop. And you would also need an adapter, because Apple's SSD has a non-standard form factor, but it is basically just an NVMe drive. It's just physically different, but electrically it is the same as an NVMe drive. And I bought this adapter on eBay. It was not very expensive. It was, I think, 9 or 10 euro plus 5 euro shipping. So yeah, this is not very expensive. And unfortunately, you will also need some special tools, because those screws on the bottom of the laptop, those are not your grandfather's Torx screws. These are actually pentalobe screws. So you would need a pentalobe screwdriver to open your laptop. You would also need a suction cup to pull off the bottom cover, because it's on there very tightly, so you will not be able to open it without a suction cup. You will also need something to open the clips that hold the bottom cover, and for this I will use this tool, which is similar to a guitar pick. So you can use a guitar pick, or maybe an old plastic card or something like that. So the first step is obviously removing the screws. And these screws, as you can see, they are all different in length. So you have to remember which screw goes where. After the screws are removed, you have to use the suction cup to lift up the cover. It's held on there very tightly. So it's easiest to leave it from the front side. And as you lift it up, you have to use the plastic pick and insert it between the cover and the case of the laptop. And then just go around until you hear the clips snap. One, two, there is just one clip on each side of the laptop, and there are no clips on the, or at least I don't think there are any clips on the backside. So I'm sorry for my clumsiness, but it's not the easiest thing to do when the camera is between me and the laptop. So basically you have to take the cover and slide it towards the front to free it up, like so. So once the cover is removed, this is actually the solid state drive that we have to replace. But before we start replacing it, we have to disconnect the battery. And the battery connector is hiding under this piece of tape. At first you have to disconnect this small cable. There is a small connector and you have to lift up its retaining tab. So you can lift it up like this, and then the cable should just slide out of the connector. So and once it's done, so you can see there is a screw here, a rather large screw, and it secures the battery connector. I think the screw uses the, I think it's T5, yeah, it's T5, or not. No, it's C5. So once you remove this screw, you can gently lift the battery connector from the board. So finally, the solid state drive. So first you have to remove this piece of black tape that is covering the connector. Rather difficult to remove, as you can see. Then just unscrew these two screws. And now we can try to lift the drive with our plastic spudger tool. So lift up and pull out. Yeah, so this is the drive that we have removed. Now we have to install our new solid state drive, and for this I will first need to take the solid state drive and install it into the adapter. And tighten up the screw. Yep. So now it's not going anywhere. And now the adapter with the new solid state drive goes into the slot on the motherboard. I think we can actually remove this piece of tape now. It's not needed. Reconnect the battery. So this large connector, by the way, is the main power connector, which supplies the power from the battery to the motherboard. And this small connector is, this small connector, it connects the auxiliary battery board to the motherboard. And the auxiliary battery board contains contains a chip that actually has the information about the battery, its age, number of cycles, and all that stuff. Okay, now this is secured. And finally, we have to put this piece of black tape back where it was. And it was approximately here. Okay, now it's time to close the laptop and we'll see if the new solid state drive actually works. Okay, so I'm back in macOS and our new internal drive shows up as untitled. And if we open it, you will see that it shows that I have 512 gigabytes available. So it definitely works, it is seen by the system. So it's formatted as a next FAT volume from the factory. And now let's actually run Blackmagic disk speed test and see if it works now. So select target drive, untitled, open, start. And it definitely works. Thank you for watching. I hope this information was useful for you. And I will put all the information and all the links into video description below. Thank you and bye.